to here, owner of Culinary Unleashed, and she's putting some beautiful roll-ups on there. And so what are those, and how do you put those babies together?
Those are, they call them the Brujols steaks. They're very thinly sliced. I tenderize them, and then I season them. And there are all some vegetables.
So you call it like Brujol, huh?
Yeah.
So that's like an Italian thing, Brujol, but yes. We're talking about doing this with a Middle Eastern twist, right?
Twist to it, yes. So that you can have your protein in the morning and you can function and your day will be delightful if you have...
What, you're kidding me? This is a breakfast item?
Yes, it's a breakfast item. I eat it for breakfast. My children eat it for breakfast.
You have just made the crew here at New Day Cleveland the happiest crew on the planet. We don't see great protein like that in the morning for breakfast.
Well,
here.
I guess it is because people are gravitated into casein protein. So why go for something that's processed when you go for the whole meat here? And then you eat vegetables, don't you, with your omelet? So why can't you just have it raw vegetables?
It looks like the ratio of vegetables is greater than you'd have it in an omelet. And there's a whole lot less fat in that beef than there is in bacon or sausage.
Exactly. And it's really very tasty. And you still will have some carbs. So at the end, I will show you the end result of the meal.
Okay, show me how to roll one of these babies up, and I'll ask you some wonderful questions here.
Look how thin the steaks are.
How did it get so thin?
Well, you have to ask the butcher, wherever you get your meat from, you need to tell them that you need it to be very thin.
And what cut do you tell them to give you?
Any cut that they have available, it is, yes.
Yeah.
And you have to tenderize it.
Stand back while you pound it.
Please do.
So how did you learn how to cook?
Just messing in the kitchen, watching my mother. It's something that I always was fantasized about. She denatured all kind of enzymes and microbials in the kitchen. And so I just was watching her all the time, and I became infatuated.
What's the spice?
So it's a mixture of a little bit of Mrs. Dash, some garlic, some lemon and pepper, a little bit of Italian herb that I grew last year, and I dried them.
Well, you're growing herbs in your backyard, huh?
I do, and
how
we also have a little farm in Medina.
Oh, so
you can.
I'm going to go look at the steak thing, see how they're doing.
You can cut these guys to your liking, and you pull one at a time. And you can take one or two, however many. I like a lot of vegetables.
I love your idea.
So
somebody was telling me that you cooked for the king and the prince when they came to the Cleveland Clinic?
I used to be their private chef, yes, back in the good old days. So they call upon me, and I enjoyed it.
You said like it's 100 years ago. That was just
yesterday
almost. It
was, yes, when I was just very young, not anymore. So that was a long time ago.
I just heard your phone ring. I think somebody's calling you.
Well, perhaps, but it's not their time right now. It's your time. So I'm here with you in the kitchen. So here's how it goes. So he's...
You tell him.
See how simple these guys are?
I love it. And you want me to turn these, or are these good?
A little bit more,
okay,
perhaps.
Good.
And here we have this sliced guy.
I love the way you do this. Who would have thought for breakfast, huh?
You know what? My children wake up and they go, Mommy, what's for breakfast? Can we have waffle? And I said, let's try to improvise and see something better than waffle.
How many
kids
do you have?
And we came up with this idea. 5.
Holy crow. Do you guys have a TV?
We do. Why?
Well, it's something else to do.
TV. They're wonderful children. They're the loves of my life.
Boys, girls?
I have 4 boys and 1 girl.
Oh boy, she's lucky. She's got protectors, huh?
Yes, kind of.
That's great.
So,
how old's your oldest?
28. So I have 28, 26, 16, 9, and 10.
Oh, that's excellent.
That is excellent.
So, did you go to school to learn how to cook?
So, for hospitality management, yes. So, part of the training is you need to know how to cook.
Yeah.
So, it's really not mainly culinary. It's just part of it.
Yeah, well, I like what you do here. So
you
do this, like you have private customers that you cook for them in their homes?
I do, yes. They email me and say, Nagam, this is what I need for a week. Or sometimes they say, we have a party next weekend. Can you come and do that for us? And sometimes I go to their home and stay over, cook for them, label it, put it in their refrigerator or their freezer so that they can have it for a week or so. So it all depends. It's a variety of ways that I do it.
Boy, that'd be great to have a party like that where you just keep making stuff, huh?
Yes, exactly.
So if this is a breakfast item, what would be like a dinner item that you would make for people?
Dinner is nothing that we consider at all. We eat very heavy breakfast, very good lunch, but no dinner. That's how we stay really healthy, because dinner, you're on your own. We have a saying back home, if I can. We don't drink. Like you eat watermelon, or you eat just plain salad with no dressing, or just a little bit of lemon or oil. that's why, you know, you stay really fit, because you take heavy food with you to bed, you're not going to be able
to
control
your
weight. Well,
you look
great. Well, thank you.
How do people get a hold of you if they would like to learn more about your cooking?
I do have a website. It's culinaryunleashed.com. They can email me there, and they can tell me exactly what they need, and we can make an arrangement. So I meet with the client, find out what they like and dislike and their allergies and what have you, to try to accommodate them, and I work around their schedule.
That is fantastic. So we see that cooking over here.
Yes.
And we see it plated up over here.
So this is it. This is the final result. It's sitting on a pita bread, and it has a little bit of a garnish, like slivered onions and tomatoes, a little bit of pomegranate. It's a Mediterranean glaze, and sriracha sauce. And these are just picnu peppers and pineapples, just a little taste.
I like the little hot with the sweet, huh?
Yes, absolutely. That's
really good. And you were talking about, you know, healthy and not eating a whole bunch, like pita bread. Like, how many pieces of that would you eat in a day?
For pita bread, you can eat a whole piece of pita bread. I've always eaten it for lunch and breakfast, and, you know.
It's terrific. So would you come back another time and help and show us how to make lunch?
Absolutely.
The next meal of the day?
Not a problem. It'll be my pleasure.
I love your breakfast.
Oh, sure. Thank you so very much for having me.